Now we have our first final of these Olympic Games of 2012. The Romanians Andrunaș and Susanu hold the world best time in this event, and they have made it through to the final, but only just. So before that we have the B final, which is quite right, of course, from Argentina, Maria Laura Abalo, journalist from Tigre, and Gabriella Best, the tallest competitor at 6 feet 1 inches tall. Representing Italy, Claudia Wurzel and Sara Bettolassi. In the boat for China today, in lane 3, Yage Zhang and Yulan Gao. Finally, from South Africa, Nadine Smith, a 24-year-old from Victoria Lake, Johannesburg, and Leanne Perse from the University of Pretoria. Well, they have a good view. The gentleman and the lady on horseback, interested in proceedings down the lake. There's the South African oar.
Argentina.
In the hands of Nadine Smith, 24-year-old.
Italy.
Who once represented China. South Africa in water polo in the championships in Rome in 2009.
Africa. Attention.
Now they can concentrate on this women's pairs event. A dull day, but nothing dull about the racing. Now, it has been dull over the 5 days of competition. We've had some brilliant sport. We really have, and some superhuman performances, some new Olympic records, personal bests, and the best start was made by South Africa. There they are, Nadine Smith, 24 years of age, and Leanne Pest, 23, studying sports science, coached by Roger Barrow. They have the early lead, just ahead of China, Zhang Yuge, Yulan. All 6 feet tall, and in the distinctive red and yellow of China. Crossing lane one for Argentina, Maria Laura Abalo, 30, a journalist, and Gabriella Best, who is studying human movement, if human movement out on the lake at the moment. You can see a difference in styles here between the Chinese and the South African combinations. But they're the two who are leading the way. The China just edging ahead, I think. No, South Africa just getting back there. It was South Africa first through in 152.6. Really knocking between themselves and China at the quarter mark of the race. Goodness me, the concentration levels are extraordinary, and the dedication levels as well, to get up every morning and break the ice sometimes on the river just to pursue your sport with nobody watching. So it's been fantastic for these competitors that there have been thousands watching here at Eton, 30,000 spectators a day coming in to witness these third Olympic Games to be staged in London. In 4 years' time, it'll be Rio that has the honour of hosting the Games. A stroke rate of 32 for both Chinese and South African boats at the moment. And that shot would suggest that China has a marginal advantage. Yellow boat from the white boat. The yellow and red of China. Zhang, 27 years of age, Gao, 29. coached by Igor Grinko. And it is China who have now got about half a length lead upon South Africa, with Italy and Argentina struggling to stay with them in lanes 1 and 2. Nothing much in the relative heights of the four ladies in the picture together. The Chinese both 6 footers and the South Africans round about the same. Later in the day we'll see a Netherlands crew of men, the smallest of whom is 6'4". So China were through the halfway point of the race first, South Africa second. Not able to contest the medals, but in this B final, having a good Olympic Games here at the moment, winning plenty of medals in the first few days of competition in London. And what's wonderful about the Olympic Games, it does bring into focus sports like rowing and volleyball and gymnastics, which are very rarely featured on a regular basis by the national media. New names come to the fore, new stars are born at Olympic Games. And who would bet against this Chinese pairing being formidable in 4 years' time in Rio? Not everybody has peaked at the top of their careers by the time they're 27. So there'll be good days ahead for Zhang Yagu. All about keeping the rhythm going, and that's what the Chinese are managing to do so far. Good race for China. South Africa yielding some more ground to them as we arrive at the three-quarter point of the race, with China over in lane 3 first, South Africa in lane 4 the second. Argentina in lane 1 just ahead of the Italians. Claudia Wurzel from the lovely area, Lake Como. And Sara Bertolassi, watching communications. Well, not communicating well enough at the moment to challenge the front two, but it is China from South Africa. Begins to shout and support the competitors in front of them. It's a wonderful thing to say that you're an Olympian, and all these 8 ladies out there can say exactly that. But there could be only one winner of the race, and China are in position to win this one, but South Africa are still just trying to keep abreast of them. The question is there a late spurt to be had? The other question is, is it grueling for the Chinese? They look to be tiring just a little bit, but their determination to hang on is to the fore. China or South Africa to take this one. China have the advantage and look as though they'll just about do it. And a good end to the race from Smith and Perse for South Africa. Have they left it a little bit too late though? I think that they've crept up marginally. They try to put on one last spurt. Chinese resolve is paying off, and I think they're going to do it. Zhang Yuge and Gao Yulan for China will take this one ahead of the South Africans, Smith, Nadine Smith and Liam Perse. It's China 1, South Africa 2, and only a second between them. Argentina over on the far side are in third place. And coming in fourth are the Italians. They did expend some energy though. It's no wonder they're shattered. 7:55.18, the winning time for the Chinese pairing of Zhang and Gao. Result for the Chinese. It was just over a second between themselves and the South African. Here is that start list: Romania, United States, Great Britain, Australia, New Zealand, and Germany. It promises to be one tumultuous final. Here are Georgetta Andrunash and Violeta Suzanu, both 36 years of age. 9 gold medals between them, hoping to make that figure 10. They struggled to get into this final. In lane 2 for the United States of America, 24-year-old Sarah Hendershot and 25-year-old Sarah Zelenka, who turned down a basketball scholarship to pursue her love of rowing. Now the favourites, Helen Glover and Heather Stanning from Great Britain. 8 World Cup wins for Glover already. Stanning, who's taken time off from her role in the Royal Artillery to row here at the Olympic Games. For Australia, Kate Hornsey, known as Horns, from Deakin University in Melbourne, and Sarah Tate, Southie, who's a fan of the Fremantle Dockers, New Rules team. For New Zealand, Juliet Haig and Rebecca Scown. World titles for Scarring. And finally for Germany here is Kirsten Hartmann from Ulm and Marlene Sinig from Krefeld. All good.
Romania, great. United States, Great Britain.
We will celebrate.
New Zealand,
7 minutes time.
Germany, attention.
6:57.29 was the time, and away they go, and we are now getting to the crunch time in the rowing of the Olympic Games of 2012. What's gone before matters not now, it's what happens today that counts. Going well in the centre of your shot in lane 4, Australia, Kate Hornsey and Sarah Tate. We won the second heat. Edging ahead of them now in lane 3 are Great Britain. Coming up in lane 6 are Germany. Once again a slow start in lane 1 for Romania. It really has been a feature of the day's racing here. But it's looking good in the early stages of this race for Great Britain's Helen Glover and Heather Stanning. Helen Glover from the Minerva Rowing Club in Bath. Who's on a sports, who came into the sport by the Sports Giant program. She was tall and they picked her out as somebody who could do well at rowing. She's done more than well. Heather Stanning, who's had wins in Munich and Lucerne and Belgrade this year. Coached by Robin Williams, the British are off to a racing start. It's a fabulous start for Glover and Stanning. And the fans in the grandstands will know that even now, even though they're not going to come into their vision for another 5 minutes or so. But for certain, Great Britain will be leading at 500 metres. They've put in a terrific spurt. It's a race that's going very much according to plan for Great Britain, who touch now in first place at 500. Second will be New Zealand. Third are Germany, fourth Australia, fifth are Romania, and the back markers of the United States are 4 5 seconds down on Great Britain already. Helen Glover and Heather Stanning trying to write their names into rowing folklore in this country. And they've given themselves a terrific advantage. A great start to the race, but there's a long way to go yet, and they know that they have to retain their focus. The discipline, the rhythm, it all has to come together as one on the day. Previous results have been encouraging. The performance in the heat was stunning, but that was on a day when conditions were quite superb for rowing. It was on the first day here, and really they could not have asked for
a better day in which to start this Olympic rowing event. Glover and Scanning with a stroke rate of 34. Hagen Scound at 36 for New Zealand. They're in the silver medal position at the moment. An enormous amount for the former champions from Romania, Andrunaș and Susanu, to do to get back into this race. We will soon be at the halfway point of the lake. The lake actually measures 2,200 metres, but you have to have a margin at either end, which is why the race is over 2,000. And there's a very good distance between the Great Britain boat in first and New Zealand in second at the moment. Great Britain heading for the gold here as they go through in 3:39.5. They have a lead of 3.5 seconds over the New Zealand pairing of Juliet Haig, the 29-year-old, and Rebecca Scound from Wanganui. Slightly more youthful, the British pairing than the New Zealanders. That counts for nothing once you're out on the lake. New Zealand, remember, finished second in their heat to Australia, but they're heading the Australians at the moment. But heading the entire field are Great Britain, Helen Glover and Heather Stanning, striking out now. They've already gone past the halfway stage of the race, but the hard yards are still to come. Hard meters, I suppose we should call them these days. Still Great Britain on their way. It promises to be a golden moment in rowing history in Great Britain. But the New Zealanders will try and push up. Hagen Scown attempting to close the gap on Glover and Scanning. Look at the crowds in the background. The flags, Union Jack is waving. Great Britain going for gold. 26-year-old Helen Glover, 27-year-old Heather Scanning. Are they the perfect combination to get gold? They appear remorseless at the moment. They are totally focused on the job in hand. The prediction was that Great Britain could win plenty of gold here at Eton Dornay. They approach the 1500 metre mark. The time is not the most critical factor. That is to get to the finishing line ahead of the second boat. They go through in 5:32.7. 5 seconds up on Hagen Scown of New Zealand, who are in the silver medal position. Hornsey and Tate for New Zealand, for Australia, are lying third at the moment. It's between these three as they go into that final 500 metres. There will be a tumultuous roar at the finishing line if Great Britain cross it first. The battle for a second goes on, but New Zealand are closing as well. A great race from Juliet Haig and Rebecca Scown of New Zealand, but Great Britain appear to have an unassailable lead, and that's why the crowd is going wild. Glover and Stanning of Great Britain. The speed matters not, the position on the lake does. The crowd roaring them home, as you would expect. Their names will be up in lights. Their names will be on the front pages of every newspaper in the country. Heather Stanning, Helen Glover. Note the names. You'll be hearing a lot of them. The job is almost done for Great Britain. They strain every muscle in their body in the search for gold, in the search to justify all those years of training. 3 World Cup wins this year, but an Olympic gold would be worth even more for Glover and Scanning. The crowd roars them to the finishing line. Great Britain are going to touch first. Great Britain are through first. And a terrific effort from Australia at the end just to pit New Zealand into second. Great Britain 1, Australia 2, New Zealand 3. The words are, they've done it. And congratulations. Gold for Glover and Stanning, the winner of the women's pair, London 2012. Gold at last, the cheering will never end. They came in as the favourites and they have justified the billing. I don't think they know quite how to celebrate. They slap the water. One of the broadest grins west of London. It's the first gold medal of the Olympic Games for Great Britain. Prince Harry is on his feet. Prince William is on his feet. Princess Anne is on her feet. And Great Britain has a gold medal at last. And it's come in rain. It's been said in the weeks prior to these Olympic Games that Glover and Stanning were likely to win the first gold of the Games for their country, and they have delivered. And it never seemed in doubt somehow. They had to do something dreadfully wrong over the closing stages to prevent their names going up in lights and to have those gold medals draped around their necks, as they will do later. It's a dream come true for Great Britain. Note the names again, Helen Glover and Heather Stanning. And it goes up alongside Redgrave and Holmes and Pinsent and Cracknell. Quantin Tate for Australia somehow got a surge on to overtake Juliet Hagan, Rebecca Scown into second place, having beaten them in the semi-final, and they made it just at the finishing line. Disappointment for New Zealand, but still they get the bronze, Australia the silver.